Hey guys, this is XAndrew2007X. Before I get further in the video, I would greatly appreciate it if you guys haven't already, check my Discord for your PlayStation 4 jailbreaking needs. And if you guys could possibly check out my original channel, XAndrew2007X, and possibly leave the bell. And then for my channel, which you currently guys are watching on, since I can't do it for myself, there should be a bell for notifications. Alright, I hope you guys enjoy the video. Hey guys, this is XAndrew2007X here with a video I believe you guys requested from Twitter as well as from my community posts. So basically in this video I will be talking to you guys that are on 505 jailbreak. If you are on 505 or higher between like 6.72, like if you're on 5.55 or 6.20, I guess this video also relates to this as well. So, before I get further in the video, I would greatly appreciate it if you guys hit the like, as well as the comments with my channel, as well as my video get out there. I would greatly appreciate it if this video could possibly get to 200 likes or more. So, in this video, I'll be talking to you guys about 505 and 6.72 jailbreak. I'm pretty sure I'm going to sound like a hypocrite throughout the entire video. So, basically, you guys are aware about a week ago, the 6.72 jailbreak came out from someone called Slurve Govey, and normally the jailbreak gets released through Spectre Dev, and it's usually pretty good, and of course throughout the time it gets more stable. So the question in this video is updating from 505 to 6.72 worth it? And throughout the entire video I'm going to explain my opinion. This is, once again, I just said it like a couple seconds ago, this is my opinion. It's up to you to take it or just do whatever. So, is it worth updating from 505 to 6.72? No, I do not believe it is currently worth updating to 6.72 from 505. However, if you are on 5.55, 6.20, or any other firmware between like 505 and 6.72, I do believe it is worth it because you will have a jailbreak and, you know, you can get games and you can start learning how to jailbreak and, you know, you can actually have a jailbreak even if it is currently unstable. So, in this background, this is basically saying a stable jailbreak. I've heard good reports that people are crashing a lot less. However, it's still not good enough for everyone to be on it. And I had told other people, if you get a kernel panic, it will not brick your console. However, it will damage your hard drive. You obviously have a hard drive in your PlayStation 4, and when it randomly just turns off, just like anything else, abruptly getting turned off is not good for it. So it's not like it's going to show any results that the hard drive is broken. However, if you get enough kernel panics, it will damage it. I had a 505, and if you guys are following me on Twitter, I've had to reinstall numerous times about 8 gigabytes, 8 terabytes of games, and it was very frustrating. However, if you have a solid state drive, I do believe you might be better. I mean, I know a solid state drive is a lot better than a hard drive, that's for sure, but it does damage your hard drive, and then obviously if the hard drive doesn't work, you lose your games and lose everything that's on the hard drive. So also, throughout the last couple of days, going from 505 to 6.72, you do get kernel panics on 505 too. So, obviously 505 is more stable than 6.72, but to this day, I'm sure other people are getting kernel panics on 505. However, I would say you probably have 7 out of 10 chances that, you know, you're going to succeed. And, you know, when this jailbreak for 6.72 came out, it was 1 out of 10. Now, I believe it's probably 4 out of 10, maybe 5 out of 10. I've been very lucky, as you guys have, you know, seen. I've been pumping out a lot of 6.72 videos out. I usually just leave it in rest mode and then just go back to it. However, in the 6 or 7 times I've done it, you know, I've been successful. And I'm sure by sometime in August, 6.72 will be acceptable for the community to use and whatever. So basically, you know, people been wanting a new jailbreak for PlayStation 4. This goes back to being a hypocrite. I wanted a new jailbreak, and so did other people. However, 505 has been out for so long that it's more stable. But the most important part about being stable and this little argument is the fact that everything is getting backported. I can play Black Ops 4 on 505 with updates just fine, and people can do mods for Black Ops 4 and other games. However, there is no JK patch, which is for like modding games on 6.72. There really isn't that much for 6.72 because of people holding back and certain issues. I had to update to GTA 1.32, and you guys saw a video of that. I was fine with that. However, once I started injecting Mira into it, it would crash the game. I have the disc. I have the legit 1.32 update for it, so there should be no reason that it crashed. So it seems like on 6.72 you can only play on like the base version, or it's tricky. And I've been testing a mod menu for GTA 5, and it's not showing positive results, as some things are still they still need updating. So if you're on 505 and you haven't already updated, I recommend that you guys don't update. If you have a spare console like I do, or a bunch of consoles like I do, then yeah, you can. I mean, I can go from 505 to 6.72 with a different console, and it really doesn't matter to me. However, if you're still on 505, don't update, I guess. Just wait for the backports. That's pretty much it. The only reason why people want the new jailbreak is for games, and for me, I guess games is like secondary. For me, I just like modding. You know, just being able to mod on Black Ops 4 Zombies sounds really dope. I'm sure Slurvgovi will make another update next week, hopefully, and it will make the 5 out of 10, maybe 7 out of 10. And I'm sure Spectre Dev is also currently working on his little exploit while he's on vacation. So it's positive news. By all means, Slurvgovi definitely helped out the community a ton for releasing this early, even if it was unstable, because on 6.72 we can backport. You know, we can have you know, homebrew and other things. It lets other devs slowly work on it rather than just waiting. So I hope you guys got something out of this video, and yeah, I really hope you guys enjoy.